No, nobody.
I'm Capriana, and I'm an interviewer here at WMAP Radio. You can tune in weekdays from 2 to 5 to catch me and some of the incredible guests that join us on our show. From doctors to authors, life coaches, actors to entrepreneurs, you can hear their stories here every day. Tune into our Long Island station, 103.9 FM weeknights from 7 to 8 in Orlando, Florida, 94.1 The Bud, and 24/7 at WMAPradio.com, where we bring you the world's most amazing people. Make us part of your day.
All right, WMAP Radio, it's Capriana. Happy Friday. So I have an amazing woman here with me. She is a reoccurring guest on our show. Her name is Sandy Hulse. She's actually one of the lead authors in our Simply Amazing Women book that's coming out. And she's also, it's part of our Simply Amazing series. So Sandy Hulse, how are you?
I'm doing great, and I'm thrilled to be back.
Thank you for coming on our show. You know, you've come on here quite a few times, and you always, you know, have some really amazing things to say. So, you know, I just want to pick up where we left off last time, but for our listeners that may not know much about your story, just, you know, give us a little catch up, you know, catch us up to speed.
Sure. You know what? I'm going to call myself a passion junkie today. It's really been on my plate lately. And I looked back, and I don't think I have ever not had a passion to do something. Mm-hmm. And I just lately in my world, I've gone from owning my own businesses. I'm in another one now, and I love it. I've loved every single one of them, and I knew when it was time to move on to start something else. I've also, you know, I've been passionate about all my hobbies and activities that I did when I was younger. And even if I was not passionate in my work world, because I was an employee and maybe I didn't like it, mm-hmm. I knew enough to move on. So next thing you know, I'm in a great place right now. I've moved from a big city to a small tourist town. And since then, I've started up a new type of business for mentoring other people to live their passions. I wrote a book called Breathe, You Got This, Fortunes Favor the Inspired. I honed my photography skills, and guess what? This year, I got into an art gallery.
Wow. Oh, wow. Yeah. Congratulations. That's an accomplishment.
Yeah, and it's really interesting because once I've moved into my small little tourist town that we've been traveling to for 30 years, mm-hmm. I just said, wait a second, why are we not living here full-time year-round? And it's been a fabulous, but what it's done is it's given me the space to bring in more and to be more creative rather than the numbers person that I have in my businesses. I'm in the mm-hmm. accounting industry, and that's a one-sided brain working world where you're always looking at numbers, and this is allowed to bring a creative side in with me as well.
Of course.
So it's just great. It's just great.
And where are you living right now?
I'm living in a fabulous little town called Tobermory, Ontario, Canada. And if you want to Google it, you're going to see tourist boats, and it's a tiny little town. And we might have between May and October 1 million people pass through. Yeah. But once the season is over, there's 800 people here for the winter.
Wow.
That's it.
And I'm sure it's beautiful there, too. I mean, I've never been to Canada before, but I mean, I've seen pictures, and I actually know somebody that lives in Canada, and it just looks so beautiful, so breathtaking.
Yeah.
I mean, that's definitely a place that would inspire me.
Yes, and it's definitely, where we live is a peninsula, and it's a world biosphere, so we have just amazing hiking trails and water activities and gigantic cliffs, and it's just fabulous. And today is an absolutely gorgeous day.
Oh, yeah, I hope you enjoyed it before this interview.
I'm trying. It's Friday.
Oh, yeah, of course. You know, the weekend's coming up, so you definitely have some time to do that. So you know, you mentioned your book. So it's called Breathe, You Got This. Tell us a little about your book.
It is completely designed to look at your passions. Don't push them aside. And if you want to get into business with a passion of yours that you keep thinking about, it's 11 chapters inspiring you why you need to go ahead and do it. Mm-hmm. And it's really, really important that if you're unhappy with what you do in your work world, that passion that you keep thinking about is dying to come to reality. Mm-hmm. And so you want to drop the fear, and learn how to go forward and do that.
And I couldn't agree more. You know, a lot of people, they live day to day just working for a job that they hate. And that's kind of, you know, a lot of people need to do that, obviously, to survive and, you know, make a paycheck. But there is definitely ways where, you know, if you have a passion for photography, there's always a way that you could incorporate your passion with making money. So is that kind of what your book kind of does for people?
Exactly. If you had a passion for, if you had a passion for making a widget, somebody in the world is going to want that widget. Many people in that world is going to want a widget. If you have a passion for looking after kids, looking after dogs, do you have a passion for art, anything, any weird delusion of grandeur thing that you have, there's people in the world that will buy it.
So is your book kind of like a roadmap on how to get to that point of actually figuring out how to make your passion into a reality and to make money?
Yes, absolutely. And you will not have competition. Mm-hmm. Nobody has competition when they're passionate about what they do and they provide a wow factor. So they provide more than what a client or a customer is looking for, then there is no competition. The biggest problem I think I see that people have is the fear of failure. They say, what if I fail? So right at your start point, you're saying, what if I fail? And so what we have to do is learn to change our mindset. Mm-hmm. Look at how wonderful your life will be when you take control and you're getting paid the value that you think you should be being paid. And that's the key, is to change that mindset around. So it's 11 chapters of being inspired to make the change. And then when you're really ready to go, we have a couple of chapters in the back to the technical side of business, what you need to do, what you need to do in order to appease the government and kind of get yourself started and get business numbers and so forth. So it's really the 11 chapters of getting you excited to make that change.
Of course. You know, everything that you're saying right now, it's kind of reminding me of one of my favorite quotes. I think it goes, you miss 100% of the chances that you don't take. So, you know, you might as well just take it. It doesn't hurt.
Exactly. And one of the chapters that I have in my book is it's Harriet Tubman, and she says, every great dream begins with a dreamer. Always remember you have within you the strength, the patience, and the passion to reach for the stars to change the world.
Wow. Has anyone ever reached out to you that has read your book, or, I mean, have you ever helped anybody that has a success story after reading one of your passages, I guess, you know, that was kind of going through a rut and then they kind of read your words and it inspired them to do something great?
I've had people come up and give me hugs.
Wow.
And it's they just so thank you. And right now, that's what I'm doing. This is I take them further. I'm mentoring them because they really want to do it. And it's okay if you don't know how to do it. That's why there's mentors out in the world. And it's really important that if you got excited reading the book, you got inspired to move forward, then surround yourself with people that are going to support you and get you to where you want to be. And that's really, really important because it's so easy for us as humans to beat ourselves up. Mm-hmm. We beat ourselves up pretty good in our brains. And the next thing you know, we get fearful and then we stop. And that's, you know, you want to surround yourself with people that will support you and keep you moving. And it's interesting. I live on this peninsula, and there's a very big mindset here where everybody just thinks they should be an employee, and they can't see outside of the box. So I just said, come on, guys, let's do this, because we live in technology now that your client isn't 50 kilometers in a circle 50 kilometers away. It's in another country. You know, your product can go to another country. Your service, your mentorship, your support services, everything can be, your client can be worldwide now, and we have to think about that. I mean, I'm in the accounting industry, and I still have some clients that I've had for years, almost 20 years. And with the technology on computers, I can jump into their program, into their their onto their computer, help them, support them, mentor them as business services, and it's all through the comfort of my home in my PJs and bunny slippers.
And how amazing is that? You know, with technology these days, you could have a job and you can work anywhere in the world. So I know there's a ton of people that like to travel around the world all while working remotely on their laptop. I mean, that's just phenomenal.
Yeah, it's a growing movement. But the most important thing is you have to love what you do. And if you take a look at your life, and if you're not happy, if you're just going to work and you're a robot, you're coming home. I mean, there was a time in my life, for sure, for 12 years I worked in the restaurant industry, and that was it. I worked to come home to play. And I really dreaded going to work. Eventually, it got boring. It was the same thing. It was repetitive. It was great hours. It was like 6:30 in the morning to 2:30, but you would never see me outside of those times at my place of work. And then next thing you know, I'm hiking, I'm cycling, I was caving in the afternoon, I was rock climbing, we have a fabulous 780-foot hiking trail here in Ontario. And so we were piecing it. My husband and I would come home, we'd have a sandwich, and then out we go for a couple of hours at night, and we're piecing it so we could get it finished.
Of course. Yeah, I mean, that sounds invigorating to say the least. I mean, it's a lot better than working six to two, you know, going hiking and, you know, experiencing these things. You know, that's what life really is about. And that's truly something amazing that a lot of people should really do.
Yeah, and what I want to talk to today is about everybody should have a passion. Be passionate about something. And far too often, I come across people and I say, well, what are you passionate about? And the words "I don't know" come out. And you want to work on that if you're saying, "I don't know." You want to sit down on a pad of paper and a pencil, your computer, and think, what would I be passionate about? What do I like? And then you want to act on those things and bring them into your world, because ultimately, passion is the driving force behind success and happiness that allows us all to live better lives.
I couldn't agree more. You know, a lot of people, they go to work and then they come home, they eat dinner, and then, you know, they go to sleep and wake back up and go to work the next day. But I think a lot of people, I mean, some of my friends that I know, a lot of them just go to work and they don't really have hobbies besides, you know, go to the gym. You know, of course, you know, we're busy in our workday, but, you know, pick up a guitar, do something that you love, like, you know, play music, go outside, take pictures, or even if you're just going for a hike a couple times a week, I mean, you could be passionate about nature as well.
It can be music, it could be your kids out playing, it could be anything, and it doesn't have to cost money. And one of the biggest problems that I'm seeing right now, and it's been in my life and my surrounding inner circle, is kids are growing up. The father and mother have looked after the kids. It's always been about the kids all the last 17 years.
Right.
And next thing you know, you got that empty nest syndrome. And many times I'll say to the mothers, what are you going to do once the kids are gone? And they're lost.
Right.
And it was interesting. They kept would say, well, I'll take my kid here, I'll take my kid here, and or I'll do this, I'll do that. Wait a second, what if your kids move away? And guess what?
Mm-hmm.
Kids in their 20s don't want their parents around.
Right.
They want to start living their lives.
Mm-hmm.
So it's interesting. I do notice that, especially moms, they go, I don't know what to do now. And if they can't reengage as a couple without parents, then we have a divorce in the making. And it's really important that parents find a new passion once the kids are on their way out. They have to. It's imperative.
You actually bring up a really good point. You know, you talk about parents having kids and then making their entire lives about the kids. And of course, that's an incredible thing. But then once the kids move away or go to college, what are they really left with doing? You know, there's no more PTA meetings. There's no more any of that. So, you know, I feel like they like lose touch with themselves. But not even just having kids, but think about, you know, young people in relationships. You know, you get into a relationship because you really like somebody and then you kind of lose touch with who you really are. So when you guys break up, you feel so empty and helpless because now you completely lost touch with who you really were. You kind of stopped, you know, going to the gym, and that's what you loved, and you stopped doing all these things because all you wanted to do was spend time with the person. But then once things end with the person, you're left with, you know, essentially nothing. And then that's probably the most heartbreaking part about, you know, a child going away to school or breaking up with somebody. You know, you're left with kind of like a piece of you missing.
Exactly. And I think it's very important that we are all aware of what keeps us excited, keeps our energy going. And when we're feeling down, this is me, it's been up and down here and there, and I go, wait a second, hang on a second, go for a walk, go for a hike, think about things. But when all of a sudden I feel like I'm a robot again, I have to go and do something different. And it is about our energy levels and being excited and being fulfilled. And our life has to have meaning, which would give us happiness. And that way we can, you know, passion is a powerful force. And if we have that, we're happy. Mm-hmm. And so it's interesting. For me, I've been in business for such a long period of time. When I hear people that are not happy in their career choices, and I say, well, why don't you just take control, and why don't you consider starting a home-based business or a business of some sort, they just don't have any idea how to get started, or they don't believe that what they really would love to do would make them money. Mm-hmm. And they'll say, well, there's too many photographers out there. There's too many artists out there. You know, the phrase starving artist. Well, guess what? Not every artist is starving.
And not every artist is them. You know, everybody has a different piece of art. You know, when it comes to photography or when it comes to drawing, everybody does something differently. So, you know what? Like, you might as well do what makes you happy and, you know, just go with it. See if you can actually do something.
And it's interesting, I sold my first business in 2013, and I said, I'm going to hone my skills in photography, and I'm going to sell my photography, and I'm going to give it away to charity, and I'm going to do all this. And I was so terrified to put it out to the public. And it took me 5 years to 3 months ago, it took me just go out and take it out to the public. And I asked, the art gallery on the peninsula is juried, and I went, just send it out and see what happens if I get in. I got in. And not only I got in, on opening house day, I sold 3 pictures.
Wow. See, and then that actually brings up the point that you made earlier in this interview, like 15 minutes ago. I mean, you said that sometimes it's the fear of failure that, you know, deters you away from doing something that you actually love.
Exactly. I was always terrified that a professional photographer would look at my picture and pick at it. And then finally I said, what? I could pick at theirs. So they want to be critical with mine, they can be critical with theirs. I'm already critical enough. So, and next thing you know, I'm in the art gallery for the next 3 months over the tourist season when a million people are coming through. So, hey, you know, I think sometimes we beat ourselves up too much in our heads. We do. And next thing you know, you gotta fire that person in your head. You gotta let them go and just go ahead and do it. And if you fail, if nobody bought my pictures this summer, then at least I did it. I tried. If I opened up a business and it didn't really go too well, I either have to take a few steps back and restructure, and maybe I'm doing something wrong. There's still people that want to buy stuff from me, but I'm doing it wrong. Or maybe it isn't for me, and at least I did it. And then it's out of my head, and I go find a better job.
Yeah, you might as well. You know, you miss 100% of the chances that you don't take. We said that earlier, but I mean, it stands true.
Yeah.
It really does. Yes. And then with what you said about art, I mean, you know, some people hate Picasso. Some people think that Michelangelo shouldn't be as famous as he should be, you know? So everybody interprets art in a different way. You know, we all we all have a different taste. I mean, when it comes to music, someone can say, I love rock, but, you know, I hate classical. And someone can say, well, how do you hate classical? It's incredible. Rock is just too loud, you know? So we all have different preferences.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Yeah, definitely. And I have to be honest with you, I'm one of the ones that doesn't like Picasso.
There's always one out there.
But it's interesting. We have to remember that if you said to yourself, I want to be a bookkeeper, but you're afraid because there's so many freelance bookkeepers, you can make your practice different. You can apply a wow factor. You can have great customer service above and beyond anybody else out there. You can increase your skill level so it's just so pristine. And next thing you know, you're far away from the rest of the pack. And that's in any industry. If you wanted to be in the dental industry, how many dentists are out there? Mm-hmm. What would you do? All you have to do is just think, what would make me different?
Right.
And I remember somebody saying, I'm one of 1,500 dentists in this gigantic city. And then he called himself the smiling doctor, and his practice went strong very, very, very quickly.
Yeah, of course.
So it's just making a difference. It's just finding a way to be a different. And if it's this is what you're passionate about, then you have the energy to fight through the challenges and make it work. If you're not passionate about it, you don't have the energy, and then you're going to give up.
You know, I just want to tune into my listeners right now. Hey, guys. So we have Sandy Holst on the phone with us. She has been on our show a numerous amount of times. She is an incredible person. She's so passionate about what she does. She's part of our upcoming book, Simply Amazing Women. She is an author of a book called Breathe, You Got This. She's a business coach. She really does it all. So, Sandy, what is one piece of advice that you would give somebody that is kind of struggling to get out of this, I guess, day-to-day life? Like, how could they better themselves and kind of ignite this passion that, you know, is deep inside them?
If it's been a long time, find someone that's going to support you. I'm right here. I'm right here. I will give you all the support, and I will talk with you and get you inspired. Just tell me what you have in mind, and I'll get you inspired to take that forward, and I'll be there along the way because I think sometimes when we go to weekend workshops to learn something, it's a weekend and then it's done, and then you go, oh, great, I'm inspired, and you just give it a week. And then it's all that paperwork and the writing you did is dropped onto a side of the desk.
Right.
You want to find a mentor that's going to take you the entire year to get you where you want to be and to safely get you where you want to be. You don't want to move so fast that you're fearful and you stop and you can't quit your job. Like, I would never ask somebody to quit their job. I would have them do a lot of homework and a lot of research and take baby steps until they feel that they're comfortable to make the jump. So one of the things I would say is take those steps without obligation. Don't be obligated that you're going to quit your job. You just keep on taking steps, researching, Google, finding people, finding your, if you feel that there's competition, who are they? Do your research, get a website. You can start a website, and it doesn't have to go live until you're ready. You can get everything in place, and you don't have to go live and quit your job until you think you're ready. Mm-hmm. So why not do that for the fun of it without any obligation?
I could not agree more. Sometimes we just need a person to push us in the right direction. So are you that person?
You bet I am.
So to anybody that was just listening right now, if they want to reach out to you, what is a good way that we would be able to kind of come in contact with you?
Sure. It's the best one is the Sandy with an I, by the way. So sandyholst.com. And on there is, on that website is two or three things I do, but it's really in mentoring, the mentoring program, and then I sign you up to a membership to Lit Up to help you create your own wealth and create your world. And we go through some of those little courses. You can do them from home. They're online. And you get a free book. Actually, you get two or three free books. Mm-hmm. And then I sign you up for an entire year. And there's payment plans and stuff like that. It's very affordable.
Of course,
and,
yeah.
And I don't care where you live. I don't care where you live. If you're in Australia, if you're in U.S., Canada, doesn't matter. Britain, Europe, doesn't matter, because it's all the same from country to country. And we have a passion. If you have a passion to be in business, take control of your own finances, and you'd be surprised how abundant you might become with your idea.
Of course, yeah. And that was sandyholst.com. That's S-A-N-D-I HOLST.com. So you just said that you are a business coach as well. So tell us about that. What got you into this?
Yeah. Well, you know, it's really interesting. When I decided I wanted to get into business, and I had no idea what I was going to do, but I wanted to take control of my own finances. And so the only thing I knew back in my 20s was some bookkeeping, so I became a freelance bookkeeper. Mm-hmm. What that got me was, now we became very high-end bookkeepers. We had clients around the world, so that's the accounting industry, and we worked with accountants and corporate lawyers. Right. But what that got me was so many different ways of seeing how somebody runs a business. So now I got 30 years of various hundreds of people running their business very well or very poorly. And then I just put all that together, and that's how I ran my business. I took in the good and I ignored the bad. And so you'd be surprised after a few decades what that does to help somebody out skip all the challenges that you can probably skip over.
Of course, yeah. So you being a business coach, I guess that's kind of what sparked your interest in becoming an author as well for Breathe You Got This, right?
You bet, because just too many people that are sitting on the fence, and I want to inspire them to take that jump.
Yeah, of course. So you're a business coach, author, and then I also see you're a certified passion test facilitator.
Yes.
What if exactly you don't is
know
that?
If you don't know what your passion is, it only takes me a couple of hours to work that out into your top three passions. I usually go to top five, mm-hmm. and after the top five, there's a certain way of doing it, and after that, I can get to your top passion. So, for example, and I know our time is almost up, but
yeah,
it's interesting.
Sure.
I was talking to somebody, and her passion was, so she wants to be in business by herself. She wants to work from home, mm-hmm. and her passion was, I love the beach. Mm-hmm. I love the sand in my toes, a good book, and a cocktail in my hand. And that's what ended up being her top passion. I said, well, that's fine. Now we're going to turn around and figure out how you can work from the beach. Mm-hmm. And we did. And so she's actually in the process right now, working her website, working everything, and she's outside doing it. She's finding beaches and picnic tables, and she's working from the beach.
Wow. Okay. So you basically found her a job that she can work remotely, but also sink her toes in the sand at the same time.
Exactly. But now it's going to be her own business. So she's getting very close to quitting and letting go of that and taking control. And she's just excited. I talk to her all the time, and she is moving forward. She literally is everything we talk about. What's her homework for the next month? Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, she's done it. So she's going to be where she wants to be in the next year.
That's truly such a remarkable thing that you do. I mean, you make such a difference in people's lives. I mean, it sounds like you completely changed this woman's life from the ground up. I mean, you know, she probably wasn't happy with where she was working. And, you know, she kind of just took you for a ride and basically said, you know, like, I love the beach. And you somehow were able to incorporate that. So, I mean, how does it feel knowing that you're changing people's lives for the better?
That's my passion. Isn't that great? Because now I get off the phone with people or Zoom or whatever, and next thing you know, I'm on a high. Mm-hmm. And it's great when you help somebody else. I mean, our whole jobs is to support other people. I mean, really, it is about helping other people. That makes, you know, if you're ever depressed, go help somebody else. Mm-hmm. Your depression disappears. And so it's just great because it just feels good, right? I had a session with somebody and I feel good getting off. Mm-hmm. I'm on the radio station talking about passion and I am now on a high.
Yeah. Of course. I mean, that's something truly incredible to do for somebody. I mean, to leave a smile on somebody's face, I mean, that always makes me feel tremendously better. If I'm having a bad day and I made someone's day a little better than mine, I mean, that makes me feel so good.
Right.
It makes the depression just basically go away.
Yeah.
It definitely
passion,
does.
Yeah, passion is energy. And just feel the power when you focus on your passions. You focus, feel the power when you focus on something that excites you.
Of course.
Even if it means jumping out of a plane.
Of course. You know, I do feel like we have to do something in our life that we are scared to do. I mean, I feel like I would be horrified to jump out of an airplane, but definitely before I die, I have to. I mean, that's just that's a bucket list goal right there. Yeah.
You only have to do it once. You don't have to do it over and over again.
I couldn't agree more. You know, we're just about almost out of time. I just want to basically ask you a question. So what would you say to people that are going through some challenges right now in their life?
Get out of your head. Stop overthinking it. You know, focus 100% on something that you want to do. Focus on that. That's law of attraction. Don't focus on the what ifs or the scary part. Focus on the positive things that of the outcome that you're looking for, and that's what you want to do. Is start. You know, you have to take the baby steps, but you have to take the step forward. And each day, take some sort of step forward.
Of course, yeah. I mean, a positive mind equals a positive life. That's something that I live by. So. I completely understand that quote. I just want to let my listeners know that your website is sandyholst.com. That's SANDIHOLST.com. She is an author of Breathe, You Got This. She's in our Simply Amazing Women book. She's a business coach. She really does it all. And, you know, she is so passionate about what she does. So definitely check out her website. So, Sandy, it was really amazing having you on our show today. You have an amazing weekend, okay?
You too. Thank you so much. It was fun.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Standing in a field of lies, I close my eyes, but I still